Where Albert Bridge was going to go.
Where Albert
Bridge
was.
After the gridlock.
After the gridlock.
Just along the embankment.
Okay, bon, moi je tout le monde. C'est chanceux que vous allez voir, vous allez voir tout le monde. Il y a Ming qui va présenter l'entrevue. Et à la fin, vous pourrez aller vous servir un petit cocktail qu'offre la maison Mouscatribe. Alors Ming,
we should light that. Charlie.
We'll go. It's all right.
Well, you've got the time. We just got to find the channel.
Voilà, il y a quelques années pour l'album, il parle des Costello, Runs, Saint-Denis and the Lash. Les gens ont fait un lancement sur un bateau démoli qui a eu autant de retentissement que l'album, parce qu'il était évidemment porté par les Pogues.
And on t'en a un
peu. Je pourrais plaider plus fort, le nouvel album s'appelle Peace and Love, il est produit par Steve Lillywhite qui a produit le dernier album qui s'appelait If I Should Fall From Grace With God. Et Steve Lillywhite a l'habitude de travailler avec des gens comme les Rolling Stones, Big Country, Susie and the Banshees. Est-ce que vous voulez plus de précisions sur ce nouvel album? C'est quand vous voulez, messieurs, dames.
We do know when it's coming.
17th of July. Hmm? 17th of July.
Et ça sortira en juillet cet album.
Juillet.
Oui.
Steve Lillywhite a toujours fait des albums très très rock avec des sons très très gros. Ça n'a rien à voir avec le disque cello, est-ce que ça se produit des pommes sans durcisse?
Well, Steve Lillywhite is used to produce records with a big, big sound. It has nothing to see with the idea of making music of Elvis Costello. Does it mean
what,
that
is Elvis Costello got a big sound?
Yes, stoke. He's got a stoke sound.
He's got a fat sound.
Alors, Elvis Costello a un putain de son.
That's joke. I mean, that's joke, you
know. Les méthodes de travail ont changé.
The way you're working these days has changed.
Yeah, we play much bigger places now. This is really good, I like this. Right, I've been heard this.
Oui, enfin bon, c'est comme on veut donc. C'est assez amusant. D'autres questions?
Tu veux rester dans le monde?
Tu peux nous raconter une histoire?
We don't know, ouais.
That's kind of story about the recording of the LP during the session.
Yeah, we dropped out the number and fell asleep.
Oui, ils sont dormis plusieurs fois pendant l'enregistrement du dernier album, donc qui s'appelle Peace and Love.
Non, mais alors,
c'est chanson. What are the different themes?
It's the same words, but the line up is the same word, apart from the rock bridges.
Je crois que le parfum des chansons du prochain album ressemble étrangement aux autres. C'est toujours faire un petit peu gaélique, compagnie, les balades et le bar. Yeah, a guy wants some explanation about the title Peace and Love.
Well, you know, I mean, Peace and Love, I don't know how to say it in French. Peace et l'amour. Peace and Love.
Oui. Did you make some covers in the new LP?
No.
Que des compositions originales.
Well, we didn't have a lot of time to record it, so as usual, it doesn't, you know.
C'est leur manière habituelle, c'est vraiment au feeling, ils ont fait leur propre production, il n'y a absolument aucune reprise.
Shane
qui a composé toutes les chansons et puis où et comment?
Ah oui.
Did you hear all the sounds and how? No. Terry Rhodes. What, you talking about
writing
and then when you talk about
writing, music and everything.
Hold on, Terry Rhodes, Sammy Rhodes, I'm all right.
He
was. Hello. Hello, Dan.
How come you don't sing all the songs? Because there's eight people in the band and other people sing as well.
Yeah, so how many are singing? Everybody?
Five.
Four.
Nice. Four.
James is the DJ. The rest of us the MC. James, where is that? James, where is that?
It's like some songs suit certain voices. You know, like if you're going to perform a song, like some people maybe they can perform a song better than someone else because they can relate to the song more. You know, someone writes a song, generally they're going to sing it best if they can sing to start with.
So much, yeah.
Yeah, some are, they're all different from each other. Well, in the same way that there's been different styles on, you know, the previous albums, there's, you know, if you just played the songs on a guitar and sang them, they'd just be like a typical folk song. But then when we come to play them as a band, like different ideas come in and they all turn out, you don't know what they're going to turn out like. So.
What new ideas do you propose?
What new ideas?
Well, this is a good one.
Well, we've got a hurdy-gurdy, that's a new idea. That drastically alters things sometimes. Hurdy-gurdy. It's like a strange medieval stringed instrument. You turn a wheel and it's like a medieval DX7 or something. It makes a horrible droning sound, so you get a horrible droning sound permeating through the whole song. And it, you know, that's really different thing. What else is different? Something else must be different.
Did you make your
hurdy-gurdy? I made it myself.
Why did you make it? Because you couldn't buy one?
The only one I could find was very expensive and it wasn't very good. So, and like, I didn't know what they sounded like really anyway, so I could have spent 1,500 quid.
What?
£1,500 that I didn't have and made something that sounded like a load of crap. So I thought I better not risk that, so I built one and at a much cheaper price.
How did you kind of design?
Well, it was a kit.
It was a kit.
Do it yourself.
Put A into B. It's one of those.
Well, it wasn't quite that straightforward, actually.
So joining the dotted lines.
Then you made the soundtrack of Sid and Nancy.
Yeah.
Then you played in Straight Away as an actor.
Yeah.
We wore a very long suit.
Set at the table.
If you didn't win an award, do you plan to make something else in this million?
I don't know, somebody asked us.
If we get the right script, you know, we get a lot of very bad scripts.
We're going to make a remake of The Stalker.
If somebody gave you the money to make a movie, what could you do?
More like what?
What?
If you're the producer,
sort of Jerry Lewis does
your own movie.
Yeah.
What would you talk about? What would you do?
Well, that's quite a probably a remake of Tarkovsky. So.
And there's so and so.
Jerry Lewis meets Tarkovsky.
I don't know. Don't talk to me about films. I'm too shy.
James isn't. He knows about films.
James is.
James is the sort of character on Stroheim.
James is the one.
His family are in films.
Qui voudrait que le pied du prochain est définitivement fixé sur scène.
Merci.
Comment?
Well, there's a rumor that said that the foot of your microphone is totally included on stage, because sometimes when you're on stage you're not clean enough to take it right.
Means
that sounds a rumor, Tommy, is
that. That's
not
to me.
C'est démenti. Record company are looking for a new brand, looking like you to. Do you think that one day record company will go to Ireland to find new pubs?
Oh,
that is so bad public image.
No.
Well,
no,
we're
I don't
also
know
from London.
We're not from Ireland.
Yeah. That's a bit of a misconception.
Sorry.
Misconception.
I'm not really from Ireland. It's a mistake to talk about us and you two together like that, because well, some of us are Irish, and the music we play is based, a lot of it anyway, in Irish music. We're not an Irish band. I suppose more than anything, we're a London band. That's what gives us our identity. So you're barking up the wrong tree, really, to put us and you two in the same. It's just obviously people are in Ireland looking for new U2s, but I don't think they're looking for new pubs. We're simply looking for new pubs in France.
No,
but it said that you two is very powerful all over Dublin. Do you think that if you're not a friend of Bono or The Edge, you have the possibility to make something?
No, 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 distinctly no is the answer to that.
Yeah, it doesn't work like
doesn't
that.
Work like that.
It doesn't work like that.
No, you don't have to know
Bono. You don't have to know Bono or The Edge or anybody from
yeah,
YouTube.
Yeah, the management.
Or the management for that matter.
What's the name of this big studio? Wimland, you know, it's a big recording studio.
Wimland.
Wimland,
yeah.
There are other studios.
We're lucky enough to be friends with Mickey Most, and he lets us use his studio.
I like playing with other people, but I've no kind of idea of producing. I don't know. I would.
No.
Where is this girl? It's a secret for a female because it's very thin and it's very feminine.
So,
and you're a girl, okay? One guy too.
There's a woman in every man, and vice versa. Casper the world. Casper the world.
More open, or is it a comeback to the roots, to a folk Irish melody?
We never left our roots. No, really, we never stopped playing folk Irish melodies. None of you
were.
Yeah.
Une dernière question, courageux, courageuse. Oui.
En reprenant un petit peu sa question, on avait beaucoup de groupes qui partaient d'un side of the rich, on peut dire qu'ils sont partis par là, et qui à un certain moment ont décidé de perdre le folk, de se lancer dans le rock. Est-ce que cela pourrait arriver avec les pubs? Est-ce que cela va arriver? Parce que quand même, Yeah Yeah Yeah, ça n'a complètement rien à voir avec leur début.
So, the single Yeah 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 has nothing to see with what you met before. And many groups, when they began the folk melody, after a while, began to produce more and more rock and roll music. Do you think that in the future, you're going to be led to make more opening music and more rock music and forget a little bit your past, your roots?
No, look, I like rock music. We all like rock music, you know.
We've already done some rock songs,
you know. Yeah, 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 it's more of a soul song, anyway.
You said London Girl.
London Girl, yeah.
The janitor of Yeah. And, you know, maybe wasn't quite so sort of immediately recognisable as a... Well, no, it was. I mean, it's the same. So it was a dance tune. Had a slightly more Cajun feel to it than Roll Roll Roll, but it's the same kind of thing, really, you know. Accordion feature. So, I mean, like we keep saying, you know, we've never been restricted to one particular style or something. We've wanted to incorporate as many styles as possible into our overall sound.
Well, we started off just playing people that don't get drunk or whatever.
So we did all sorts of different numbers, you know. But over the sides of the orientation, just, you know, I mean, I can't see why not having an acoustic line, a semi-acoustic line, wherever you want to call it, should stop you playing anything you want to play, really.
Well, do you think, like, your kind of music belongs on a big stage like here tonight, or bigger stages that you've played on?
Belongs
wherever.
Like, you know, like, we could play in a place this size.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Well,
maybe it's better in a pub or...
No,
I don't think you could say it's better or worse.
It depends on how you project it. That's all, you know? I mean, if you can put it across in a big stadium or in a big hall, as well as you can do it in a small club or a pub, then it's all well and good, you know?
Did you have to change something
really?
In how you play it?
No.
You just turn your amplifier
up. Just turn it up
to full volume, yeah.
Let's get 100 watts instead of 50. And you've got to bear in mind that there are sort of that many more people out towards the back, you know, I mean, that maybe you can't even see, like in some places, but there's no reason why it should be any different.
If you two can do that, why can't we?